Okay, guys, instead of going out for a romantic Valentine's Day meal, our next guest says, why not enjoy a cozy night at home instead?
Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
That's what I'll be doing. Here with some ideas to help celebrate with your sweetheart, the kids, even friends. Welcome back, America's CEO, that is Chief Entertaining Officer, Tim Laird. Welcome back to Houston Life.
Great to be back, Courtney and Derek. And yeah, we have some fun ideas. You know, it doesn't have to be a romantic occasion. It can, but I'll tell you what, we always like to entertain. And we've got a great idea to turn an inside movie night with a themed food. So I'll give you some ideas, but first, how about a cocktail?
No, thanks.
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
We're going to start out with my Ruby Valentino, and it's ruby because it's going to be a ruby red in color. Starts out with 2 ounces of pomegranate juice.
Ooh, nice.
To that, I'm going to add about 4 ounces of this Korbel Brut Rosé.
All right.
So it's Brut and rosé, so Brut meaning dry, and rosé, we learned from Champagne School.
Yes.
It's a nice little rosé from the Pinot Noir grapes. The skin of that gives it that nice color. There it is, and I garnish it with a little candy heart spear if you want.
Beautiful.
But here it is, my Ruby
Cute
Valentino.
Idea.
Very easy to make.
I love
delicious.
It.
Delicious. I love the color, too. Isn't that delicious?
Cheers
and
to
the
you.
Candy hearts, and I've been saying Brut wrong all these years as well. It's not Brut, it's Brut?
Brut. You know what? That's one of those things you can say different.
Tomato, tomato.
Okay.
But,
so however you want it, it's fine with us. And I like the idea, easy to drink from glasses. So.
Absolutely. You know what I love about your spread, Tim, is that it's great if you want to go out to Valentine's Day into a restaurant, but most of the time, sort of like the bigger holidays, it's a set menu. So
and it's expensive.
Family, it's expensive.
And you're fighting crowds.
During the week.
Totally.
Yeah, so that's my, that's a great inside tip because you know what? Go there other times. But, and here's my idea. How about creating food to go with a movie? So, for example, how about a big plate of pasta that's inexpensive to make and you can show that with movies like Big Night, Godfather, or the famous Lady and the Tramp spaghetti scene? Yes.
Could we reenact that right at this
I think
this
we
very
need longer
moment.
Noodles. But
I feel like we need to.
That is fun.
And that is a ton of spaghetti right there.
And you can try this. Now, I've got two secrets to this recipe. First of all, it's called my pasta Angelo, and it was taught to me by a Chicago restaurant owner, and he's told me the secret. One is start out with a skillet, render off the fat from 2 pieces of bacon. That's all you. It's not a lot of fat, but I'll tell you what, that bacon fat adds so much flavor. And then add shallots and garlic and your tomato sauce. And then his second secret, a little bit of cream, just a little bit, not a lot, to give it a nice little rouge color, and it's delicious. Very
easy.
Isn't it delicious?
And it is such a great idea, Tim, because as you mentioned, it's a lot of food, not a lot of money to make that
right.
dish.
Right. Oh, and it's fun. And everybody
and
likes it. And everybody can get involved. If you want to put on more Parmesan cheese, I always leave some out to if your guests want to grate more on there. Perfect. I see it's a big hit. See the two secrets? A little bit of bacon fat, because we know fat is flavor.
Oh, so good. Okay.
And moving on, chocolate.
Popcorn is, in my opinion, a food group.
It is a food group. And if you're showing popcorn. Movies at home, you've got to have popcorn. I'm moving on to kind of a chocolate theme. So if you want to show Au Chocolat or Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, this is basically kettle corn, microwave. I make it easy. And then for the chocolate, I just sift over a little bit of cocoa powder.
Oh.
So you have this little chocolate going on, which is wonderful.
Unexpected.
With the kettle corn. So it's very easy to make.
Oh,
something a little different. Yeah.
Wait, that's just cocoa on top?
That's just a little bit of cocoa.
Beautiful.
I just sifted a little bit of cocoa on kettle corn. Isn't that great?
You know, honestly, I did not expect it to taste like much, but this is delicious.
It's a way to kick up your popcorn.
All right.
No wonder you're the CEO.
Yeah, we always try different things. Also, red wine and chocolate is a perfect pairing because basically the vanilla and the chocolate will bring out the vanilla notes from the oak aging of the red wine. So what I do, and here's a fun entertaining tip, ahead of time, I'll take dark chocolate chips.
Look at that.
Melt them in the microwave. Then dip your red wine glass in that, and it sets up, and you have the chocolate here. So when you take a sip of the red wine,
genius.
You'll get a little
beautiful.
Taste of the chocolate. Isn't that great?
And what a fun surprise for your
these.
Friends or your significant other.
Seriously, brilliant.
And you get a taste of the chocolate, a little taste of the
it's
red
so
wine.
It's so fancy. It's so fancy, but doesn't require that much time, money, or
hell. But isn't that good? So amazing.
I'm using a little Sonoma Cutrer Pinot Noir.
That's very nice.
And it's wonderful. But I like this, too. At the end of the night, you can watch your guests kind of lick the glass, and then they have chocolate on. But it's fun. It's a fun
thing. Get there. Oh, you're doing that. You hide your face with those cards. Listen, Tim, I have these cups at home I didn't use over New Year's Eve. What did you put in here?
I'll tell you what you can do with these little chocolate cups, which you can get at party centers or online. Basically, you can fill them up with cordials. Like right here, I've got a black raspberry liqueur, Chambord. Where do you try that in a cup? Or you can fill it with chocolate mousse.
Do you drink? Do you drink it, or you just shove it all in your face?
Either. Well, I like to drink it, and then you can eat the.
Then you eat the glass.
Eat the glass.
Why do the dishes when you can just eat them?
Yeah, it's like Willy Wonka. You can even eat the dishes, right? Is that what? Isn't that good? You get the chocolate and the black raspberry. How good is
that? Amazing.
Wait, where do you get those? Craft stores?
You can get it online, party stores.
I got it at Specs.
Specs, there you go.
Yeah, I think even the grocery stores in like the dessert area have them.
Holy cow. Last but not least, Tim, what you got there in that martini?
Here's a nice sweet ending. Basically, I take some whipped cream, put a little bit of that black raspberry liqueur, the Chambord, mix that up, and then set out strawberries. So actually, you can take your strawberry there if you want. Your guests can dip it in that Chambord.
A dipped strawberry.
And then you have that.
That's so
take a
pretty.
Bite of that, and then you can drink your champagne or your wine, and
this is covered.
Tim, these are great ideas. We got to leave it there. We have, by the way, shared all of Tim's recipes on our website, HoustonLife.tv. Just look under the food section. Tim, thank you for lunch and dessert.
Cheers.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Thanks for coming in.